3 years ago, I made this little video, which explains the main reason why I don't use Linux as a primary OS. Basically, this was because I had experienced a lot of failed updates in the past. But now I have changed my mind, and I thought I should just make a quick video which explains why this is. The thing is that I haven't experienced any major problems with Linux since then. Every update has just worked fine, and I just recently updated to version 18.04 of Lubuntu. I also bought a Epson printer last year, which I tried to install a Linux driver for, which worked just fine. I was quite surprised that there wasn't any problems at all. So, my attitude towards Linux is much better nowadays. One of the arguments I had against Linux earlier was that there wasn't any GUI-based utility for setting up partitions on a hard disk. But then I discovered this. Which I really liked the layout here, especially the way the partition information is shown, and the fact that it is possible to make backups of a partition, which is really nice, because I really like to have backups of my operating system partitions in case something goes wrong, so that I can just restore the partition from a backup. I really like this program. The stability of Linux is actually a good reason for me to migrate over to Linux now. But there is also another reason, that is that next year Microsoft's support for Windows 7 ends. So that the only safe option then is Windows 10, which I really don't like at all, because I need a computer that doesn't include any spyware and that has a desktop meant to be used for computers. I also find it somewhat cumbersome to use. And the start menu is just a train wreck, in my opinion. And having to install third-party stuff just to get basic OS functionality, like a start menu in a more classic style, is not something that I want to be bothered with. So, I prefer a start menu that is more in this style. Quite simple and quick to start stuff. The Windows 10 variant is not something for me. Furthermore, I also want to use my computer when I want to use it, and I also want to turn it off when I want to turn it off. In other words, I want freedom to use my computer whatever I like, whenever I like it. That being said, I have a Windows 10 computer for gaming and a laptop, a small laptop for simple web surfing. That is the only computers I want to have Windows 10 on. I don't see a future with Windows 10 as a main operating system. But the migration from using Windows 7 as an operating system over to Linux has to be done gradually. Because there are certain things that I need to find Linux variants for certain types of programs and such. I can also mention that many of the old arguments I had against Linux earlier is no longer valid, since a lot of stuff has been fixed, and the old problem, many of the old problems, is not long, is no longer true. I got distracted there from the message. I can also mention the computer to write there, which is a project that I did last year. It is a computer that serves as a NAS server and has Lubuntu installed. It doesn't have a monitor attached to it. Instead, I use TightVNC for accessing the desktop on another computer. You can see here is my network shares. And just to access the desktop on this server PC, and just connect here. The nasty PC, as I call it, was built from parts and bought from eBay, while certain other parts I already had. This includes two of the hard disks that is present, a Samsung and a Western Digital Green hard disk. Well, the Western Digital Red was bought brand new, 4 terabyte one. It was a quite a fun little project that I did. I had a backup plan in case I didn't get things to work like I wanted to. That plan was to install Windows instead. But I would have looked upon that as a big defeat, because I really wanted to make this server PC Linux-based. I'll show you later why this is. There are a couple of minor issues with using TightVNC like it's done on this computer. And one of these things is that it opens up a secondary desktop instead of using the main desktop. This means that shutting down by using the function here will not work, because the window that opens up on screen will be only shown on the main desktop. not the secondary desktop that is shown there. So instead I made this shortcuts for rebooting or shutting down the computer. Another minor issue, I don't know if it's shown here. Yes, it's shown here. The title bar here, along with these gadgets, may not appear. But this, I consider this to be a minor issue, so that doesn't bother me much at all. One of the reasons why I wanted to use Lubuntu or a Linux distribution at all was that I can access much easier from my Amiga computer's network shares. This isn't so easy to achieve with Windows. So I can go into this and this allows me to mount ISO images here via the network shares on my Amiga, so I can access the contents of the ISO images there. This isn't possible to do with Windows because although I can manage to mount network shares, Windows network shares for on Amiga, I cannot access the files there. So that's why I really wanted to install Linux. I use Linux for this project. Other network shares. I don't want to show what files, the other files there is in there, especially the movies I downloaded and all. But I also have, for my Amigas, I have WHD load games, so I can extract them directly from the network share, as long as the Amiga is connected to the network, that is. Actually, I can find really really nice functionality. Okay. This was just meant to be a quick demonstration of my NAS server, which was really a fun little project that I did. I'm very happy that I got everything to work exactly like I wanted to. Okay, this is it for now. Thanks for watching.